Well, Paul Harrison was a royal correspondent for British television. He also has an extraordinary personal connection with the Queen. He joins us now. Paul, it's good to see you on this very sad day. We're going to get to your connection in a moment, but you've covered the Queen, the royal family, for so long, and obviously this moment was expected, it was planned for. Does that make it any less emotional for the UK today?
No. I don't think it does. I think you're right to point out that this has been a long time coming and there's been a lot of preparation, and it was always this subject that you could never speak about publicly, but you always knew would eventually come one day. And of course, you know, the media here in the UK and of course around the world have you know, always known that they'd have to be ready for this moment, ready for the huge impact that the death of the Queen would have, not just on Britain, but on the Commonwealth and really right around the world. And you know, the Queen met so many people. She touched so many people's hearts right around the world. Whether that was at garden parties that she was hosting, whether royal tours right around the world to Commonwealth states and realms, including Australia. She met so many people. She must have shaken the hands and given moments to tens, if not hundreds of thousands, possibly millions of people during her 70-year reign. And every single time she met someone, she always gave that very special moment to people, made it feel very personal. And I'm minded, actually, of a moment back in 2012, which was the Diamond Jubilee media reception at Buckingham Palace. And it was, if you were beamed into that moment from outer space, you'd have seen a line of around 150 journalists queuing up to shake the hands of the Queen and Duke of Edinburgh. And, you know, some of them were, you know, in many ways quite staunch Republicans as well. But she had this real ability to connect with people and make them feel like that moment was very special. So I think it's going to be really, it's going to have a massive impact to a lot of people right around the world, and a lot of sadness already. You can see that right around the UK.
Paul, you've witnessed that magic up close and, in fact, met Her Majesty many times. How was she different in person to the public figure that the rest of us knew?
Well, you know, I don't think she was that different. You know, with the Queen, she was very grounded in many ways. Obviously, she had the sort of trappings of royalty, which for some people may have felt that that detached her, but really it didn't. And so the woman that you saw on TV screens, the woman who turned up to, you know, royal engagements and royal tours around the world was pretty much the same person that you would meet if you met her in person. And I did. I met her quite a few times. And you got the sense that she was very much the same person as she was that you saw on the television. So I think she managed that real skill of just being very much her own person and didn't, you know, I mean, she understood there was some degree of theatre around what she did when she was out and about. But she never really let that change her character. She never switched kind of personalities. She was just the Queen, whether she was in private or in public.
Paul, beyond those meetings with her, you've got, I think it's fair to say, an unusual connection with the Queen, and this is going back in time somewhat. Your father, I think, was a foreign correspondent working overseas around the time that your mother was due to give birth to you. What happened?
Yeah, long story. I'll try and make it as brief as possible. But 1973, my mother was about to give birth to me. My father, however, was in Canada with the Queen and Duke of Edinburgh on their royal tour when my mother went into labour. Now, he tried to get a flight back. Back then, of course, there was probably just one flight a day. It was booked. He was going to miss my birth. He had a conversation in the bar that night with the private secretary to the Queen, who went to the Queen and relayed that message. And her response was, well, tell your John Harrison, my father, tell him he can travel back on our royal flight. She was travelling back to London the very next day. And so he was able to be back in London for my birth within a matter of hours. And, you know, if you then fast forward 37 years, I'm by then, of course, out of nappies, but now as royal correspondent, I was Royal Correspondent for Sky, and I found myself, you guessed it, back in Canada with the Queen and Duke of Edinburgh, with the press secretary, a great Aussie, Samantha Cohen, who was the press secretary at the time. She let me know that there was another engagement on the list. I flicked through the royal engagements. I said, no, I think you're wrong. And she said, no, you have one more engagement. She led me up into the centre of a garden party, and the penny dropped. I was about to have a private audience with the Queen, and I thought, what on earth? What on earth do you say to her when you've been given a matter of seconds and you're told you're having a private audience with the Queen? And then I thought, my mum had always said I would love to thank the Queen for that really kind gesture that she made back in 1973, getting her husband back to the UK in time for my birth. So I thanked the Queen personally on behalf of my mum and, of course, for me, and said thank you. And she responded, characteristically in an understated way. We were very glad to have been of help, of course.
Oh, what a special moment. Great story.
Extraordinary story, Paul. It's great to talk to you. We really appreciate you sharing that with us here in Australia.
My pleasure. Good to see you.